Hey, and welcome back to The Walking Dead. And we're in a bit of stickuation. Yeah, you can use that one. Stuck in a bungalow, and we're surrounded, and Sarah doesn't feel like moving because she's got other things on her mind. But I think I'm gonna try and convince her, because I just can't leave a man or a woman behind. Yes! Come on, Sarah. Come on, baby. Come on.
Snap out of it, Sarah.
Daddy can't help you anymore.
You can't save her, Clem. We have to go.
Bro, she's my bro, though.
I know
bro.
About this.
Hurry up.
Bro, bro, bro. Slap her.
Move.
Wake up. Damn it, it didn't work. Shit.
Clementine,
shit.
Grab her.
It worked. What? Yeah. I told you I could save her. Come on, come on, come on, come on. No, no, no. Yeah, okay, I was. I really don't want her to die. She's
go.
Such a badass.
Sarah.
Come on.
A complete badass. Come on, Sarah. You can do it, little buddy. You're older than me. You should have this together. You should have this down pat. I'm really surprised that Nick couldn't just, you know, go over the fence and run that way. Why did Nick go the other way? This seems like a really easy way to go, too.
Okay. Look, I hate to ask this, but are we there yet?
No.
We're
Does
not
it
far.
Look like we're there yet? Okay. We'll
Look, Sarah, you can get through this. We both will. But I'm not okay.
Yeah, I know,
Just
I know, but we're
try.
Friends.
Can you do that? She just needs
Can't have you dying on me, man.
Leave her be for a bit.
I suppose it was just like yesterday night that this happened, so
I don't know about this.
I can give her a little time.
The way she
just
is,
to think it through.
She's gonna cause problems.
Yeah. I know. You're trying to chop everybody's head off, but shh.
When
just
we went in
just
there,
for a little
we were
bit.
Ready to help, but then something changed. Look, I'd seen that kind of thing before. I just didn't want to stick around for the bitter end. Sorry, I don't mean to sound harsh.
It's okay, I get it. Things aren't always simple.
And just because you got her out of there today, doesn't mean you saved her. Trust me.
Yeah,
I
know. I
tried to save Jamie too, but she gave up.
It doesn't always work, but this time, it did. And next time, it will.
As soon as you guys said go, I was the first one up on the roof. Like I had already made up my mind.
Luke, you can't let it eat away at you.
Luke, you just wanted to get out of there, man. Like, it's not like you weren't going to leave us behind
Why
or something.
Forget it.
You foo.
I dragged my sister across four states. And every morning she'd say she wasn't getting up. So I'd convince her. Or push her. Or goddamn carry her if I had to. Until this time, walkers cornered us, forced us up to the roof, and when they kept coming, I couldn't make her jump, couldn't throw her. So I tried something else. I told her she could have what she wanted, and I left her there. Jumped
Cold.
And was falling over by myself.
You left your sister?
Jane, I'm really sorry.
Killed me for a long time. But I finally realized that I'd put her on a forced march through hell when all she really wanted was for me to let her go. Sarah was that way too.
I wouldn't say that's true.
Jane?
Nah, man.
No regard for her own safety.
I would say that
ours.
The reason
Sarah isn't
is because it's too much
She'll
traveling,
okay.
man. It's
Fine.
Too much.
Just be careful.
I think that's partly the reason
Come
why
on.
All these groups
Let's get
die.
Back to your friends.
Because they just keep traveling, they keep traveling, they keep traveling, and they never get time to rest. So they eventually are so tired that they start making horrible decisions, they're all pissed off at each other, and then they eventually disperse and everything goes to shit, and then everybody dies. You gotta find a place, you gotta settle down, you can't be always on the move.
Yeah, I'm a little amazed myself, to tell you the truth.
No big deal!
For Clem and Jane, well... I don't know what would have happened.
Sarah. How you doing, hon?
She's, not so great.
That's okay, sweetie. Whenever you're ready, I'm just glad you're here. But wait, wait. Where's Nick?
Rebecca, how about we go for a walk for a minute?
Nick wasn't hers.
I have something I need to talk to you about, too.
No.
Why is... I thought she didn't even like Nick. Man. Like, they were all ready to kill him when he killed that guy.
That baby's coming even faster than Rebecca's letting on.
I knew.
I was hoping you might know. Does Luke know anything about babies?
He doesn't know shit!
Has he, I don't know, mentioned Carlos teaching
him anything? Kenny knows about babies.
Kenny had a family. He could help. Where is he?
Did Kenny run off again? I hope he's doing something useful with his time. Did he build that?
He was in there after he left. Said he needed a minute by himself. I ain't seen him since.
We need to get him to come out. I've seen him like this before. I'll go in there.
I'll go in there. Thank you, Clem. I really do think that might be best.
I don't think it's going to be best. I think it's a bad idea, because I keep making bad choices. So I think it's a bad idea. I think we should get him to come out, but he might go crazy too. Maybe if I can just go in there and talk to him for a little bit, maybe he'll feel better. But last time he just told me to fuck off, so I don't know if it's going to work. He doesn't like me anymore. Oh, yeah, that's right. This is the pressy one. I always forget that. Okay, and this way. There we are. Kenny! Press and hold the left mouse button to grab. Alright. It's not healthy to stare at a wall, Kenny. Are you high? Are you smoking grass?
Kenny, could you please come out?
What the hell's the point? You know what it feels like to get beaten almost to death. Peaceful. It feels peaceful. It was like I was floating away, watching the whole thing happen to me. And then I woke up again, and nothing's changed. I'm still taking a beating. Every day. Duck. Katya. Sarita. No peace.
Yeah, let's just let him talk for a minute.
The punches just keep coming. Why the hell couldn't Carver have just finished me off? Obviously, I ain't helping anyone by being here.
Yeah, you are. You've helped us so many times.
That's not true. You help me all the time. I need you.
I've seen you take care of yourself more than any three adults put together.
yeah. I'm pretty cool. It's because you taught me, man. You taught me so many things.
Nah, don't worry yourself about this. It's nothing. Hadn't killed me yet, anyway.
I think he's snapping out of it. Well, it's nothing an old man can't take. Oh, it's probably... Oh, it's gross. It's disgusting. Oh, my God, it's disgusting. You look fantastic!
What are we supposed to do?
We should see what's going on.
I think he's gonna be fine. I was scared there for a minute. I didn't think he was coming back. Oh, it's coming. It's coming.
Are you okay? How does it feel?
It feels wet. That's how it feels.
Oh, her water broke.
Rebecca's water broke.
Oh, God. It was too early.
Oh, Christ.
What we should do.
Oh, fuck.
What do we do?
Well, what do we do?
Kenny, thank God. I think the baby's coming. What do we do?
All right, I was in the hospital
give me a
one time
no way can
when I was,
like this.
When I had my kid.
She's gonna make a lot of noise.
Smell
her, too. Now you got
what's
no
first?
To
let's let Kenny take charge, and then he
first,
can, like...
Kenny?
I think it'll help him.
Come on, you gotta focus.
Right, sorry. Clean
if we get him doing something.
In blankets.
And we gotta get out of this
he'll be okay.
Cold, too.
That map shows a couple of buildings nearby. Maybe one of them could do the trick.
It doesn't look like there's much of a building. It looks more just like a wall.
Museum seems like it could be a good start. I'll go.
Good idea. Mike, think you could go with her?
Sure thing.
I'll check the building by the river.
Okay, then. Kenny, you stick with Rebecca, and I will check the perimeter for walkers.
Okie dokie.
Sarah
is no hum.
Rebecca and Kenny, okay?
Sarah is no hum.
I know it must have been hard, but thank you for talking to Kenny. I'd love for you to give me and Mike a hand looking at the museum, but I was thinking, how do we know Jane ain't just gonna take off? Maybe you should go with her. Make sure
she's getting... Back.
What do you mean by that?
She's getting real skittish.
You know,
the more I talk to her, the more she's like, I'm leaving!
And she volunteered to head off awful fast. I guess it could be...
I trust her.
She's helped us so far. Yeah, no, you're right. Maybe it's nothing. Just.
I mean, really. If she wants to go, she can go. It's her own choice.
Okay.
It'd be nice to have her along, because I freaking love Jane, dude. I want to check on Sarah. Yeah, I want to check on Sarah first.
I'll help everyone else, too.
I think that'd be good.
Yeah, sure.
All right, everyone.
Because I like Jane.
Let's be fast, and let's be careful.
But if she wants to go, it's her own choice. I mean, she's earned it. She's helped us this far. And Sarah, she needs some help.
Rebecca's starting. They were going to leave me, weren't they?
Hell nah.
Of course not. Luke tried really hard to get you to come with him. How come you didn't leave me?
Because you're my buddy.
Because we're friends. I could never be that good of a friend. I just want my dad. I know.
Well, just remember that for next time. Ormead. I'll remember that.
Back to the cabin. We're safe there.
That cabin was friggin' sick, dude, but I don't think it's gonna work, dude.
Sarah, your dad. You know he isn't coming, right? Sarah?
Hey.
She doesn't want to let go.
She can take for now. She'll be all right.
The others could really use a hand scout for supplies.
I think she's like. I think she's slightly autistic.
Mike and Bonnie need any help.
Good. Don't be too long if you can help it.
Because if anything, it seems like if anything changes in her life in any way, she just trips out.
I guess that's the place there.
She probably has some. I don't know. House.
It's a wreck.
You ain't even been inside yet.
Just look at it. Glass all.
Dude, I can see. Even if we kill all these walkers,
No way to find out until we go and check it out for
doesn't
ourselves.
Look very safe,
this doesn't look like a very safe place to have a baby. Yeah, well, we should still look it over anyway.
Yeah, let's do it anyway. See all these walkers?
Maybe.
It's fine.
Sorry. I just really want sticking with y'all to work out. And it's been hard so far.
How about you make it up to us by helping out with those walkers up there?
I think yeah, let's kill them all. Let's do that. I mean, look, it's an open warehouse. It's too open.
Come on, Mike. We can do it.
We need, like, a building with some really tight rooms and a lot of them so we can, like, escape into one room. Escape. Holy shit. Holy shit. Yeah. Wait, somebody say something? Hip-ha! Yeah. Wait.
That wasn't so bad.
Where's this? Is this the museum?
More of them show up.
Yeah.
Watch out for the broken glass. It's all over. Okay.
Somebody's already been through here. Guess that's not a surprise.
I thought so.
Still.
I don't think there's going to be any rooms in this building that are going to be any good for like a baby anyway.
I hope whoever it was left already. We'll be fast.
Let's just take a sweep. I really don't want to go back empty-handed.
A real quick sweep. We could have a baby inside this cannon. Maybe. Babies like cannons.
I don't want nothing sneaking up on us.
Not really much point in checking it, because it's just going to be a little thing. I want to go over here and see this man. Maybe he's got some information for me.
Souvenirs, huh? Looking for a keychain with your name on it? No.
Yeah.
Why would I want a keychain? I don't even have any keys. Ah, good point.
For fun. She's just making conversation, Clemmy. No Don't be so rude. You gotta be nice to people, man. Or people aren't gonna like you.
Say that stuff about water and blankets just to get.
And you're not gonna be able to go parties and stuff.
Oh, you don't know what the hell you're talking about.
Nobody's gonna want to be at the party you're at.
No.
If you're a huge bitch. E.
You think these work?
That'd be nice.
They're just for show. Be handy though.
Also, really loud.
Good point.
Yeah, they wouldn't be handy at all. Trust me. And the ends are probably plugged, because that's usually what they do. They plug the ends, and they take out the wicks and, like, plug them all up. So you can't use them ever again, pretty much. Unless you're, like, a blacksmith.
There's sure been some animals through here.
I've been to a couple museums. Alright. Oh, is there any bunnies? Is there any rabbits? I want there to be rabbits. I love rabbits. Rabbits are my favorite animal.
Any luck?
No, nothing
yet.
Unless you want some broken glass.
Ooh, dude, this would be a really good place. A really good place to get some knives, yo.
I tell you, I sure don't like being near a graveyard with the world the way it is now.
I could totally see. See, look, don't these look like knives or like shovels or something?
Yeah, true enough.
They look useful. Boop. Closed for business until further. Oh, there looks like something I want in there. I need to get in there. Is that a map?
Empty.
Poo. Alright, I want to go in there. Because I can see another water jug in there, and I think it's full. Or at least it's got some water in it. Come on, bust down this door.
I sure hope we can find something to take back.
Me too.
Close. Doesn't seem to be any way to open it either. Maybe there's another way in from the outside. Because I don't think they would leave that open just for fun. Hello there. Come on, let me up the stairs. Guess that's not going to happen. All right. Well, maybe I'll just take a little mosey on over here. I bet there's something with my name written all over it behind this cubicle. Or maybe not all over it. Maybe half over it? Maybe a quarter? I don't know. It's probably written on it, though. Somewhere. Maybe on the bottom. That's where I like things written. The bottom. Giggity. Guys, I don't think there's anything in this museum, yo. What if we go outside? I don't want to be in here. It's scary. Yeah, this was useless. This is a completely open building. Come on, there's gotta be something. And I can't get up here for some reason. And I can't go outside either. So, I believe I will take a little trip down memory lane. Over here, the cannons from Gettysburg. Aren't they beautiful, majestic, powerful? They could blow a man's face clean right off. So don't touch me.
Not so far, but let's give the place a good going over.
I remember back when I went against the Makota. They could smell fear just by looking at you. So keep quiet.
Lee would have loved this place.
Yeah, it's a pretty good map, isn't it? Aw, don't talk like that.
Lee would have liked it if he was here, if he wasn't dead.
Guys, I think we should give up. Seriously, guys. This is dumb. Ah, what's that? Is that a shirt? Oh, it's a blanket? Ooh, show me the money, baby.
Hey, it is. An old coat. Nice. Good find, Clem.
Maybe I'll wear it.
It's gonna get a lot colder before it starts getting warmer.
We could use it as a blanket.
Kenny said we need blankets. It's not really a blanket, but... But it should do the trick.
It's so flat.
What? I guess you've already got that old coat I gave you.
Yeah, it's pretty nice, isn't it?
So bad about everything.
Making me look ugly?
Hopefully you won't always think of me like that. Not that I blame you if you did. I haven't always used the best judgment. You finally opened your eyes about Carver and what a bad person he was. That's something. Yeah.
Took you long enough, though.
Clem found a jacket.
That's great, but isn't gray the, you know,
It's not my color.
We can't put
makes me look fat.
In a Confederate coat.
Oh, I didn't even think about that.
Guess it's better than nothing, though.
You're thinking about racism right now? We can't put her in a Confederate coat, Seth. Those racist pieces of crap. Dude, it's a coat. Does it really even matter? Good joke, though. If it was a joke. If it wasn't, well. Oh, he moved. So the only reason I couldn't go in this door was because his fat ass was in the way. Telltale, why do you do these things? Like, if it was me, I always try and play as if it was me in real life, and that is such a bad thing to do, because, yeah, they want you to do a certain thing at a certain time. But I want to do it when I want to do it. Alright, what's in the box? Show me the money, baby! Money shot! Alright, let's try and open it. Nice, there's water in there.
Over here.
I don't know if we're gonna be able to carry this whole jug though.
Water.
It's big.
Bottles
it's full of water.
It's just what we need.
Yeah. Yes, exactly what we need.
It's locked.
Come on, jiggle it.
You wanna kick it down?
That'd make an awful lot of noise.
Yeah, maybe. You know, if somebody was small enough, they could maybe squeeze through that gap there.
Maybe if they were small.
Pry it open
so.
But I don't know if that'll help much.
All right.
Maybe. All right.
I gotta do all the work around here.
Thanks,
damn.
Just open the door from the other side. Mike will carry those things out. Might be a bit heavy for you.
What? You saying I'm weak? You saying I'm weak, bitch? I'll show you strength.
I'm stuck. Okay.
You better watch the Clemster.
Maybe I push from.
Just push my ass. Oh! Pull me back. Get me out of here. Get me out of here. What are you waiting for? That's right, bitch.
Do it!
Man, just kill him. Ooh, kill him! Man, you handle that zombie like
well,
a pro.
That happened.
It did. Thanks, Mike.
Yeah. No problem.
I'm so sorry about that, Clementine. We should have been more careful.
Were you trying? Did she do that on purpose? You did that on purpose.
Got something to bring back.
I'll keep checking the other room.
We got two. Not just one. We got two bottles of water. I like how Bonnie is one of those type of characters that whenever something heavy happens, she just evaporates. Nice. Thanks, boss. I think I could carry it. I think I could carry it a little way, but I don't think I could carry it the whole way back.
Pretty heavy.
That's all right.
I got it.
I know it looks like a lot, but we could all go through this pretty quick. Carver was crazy, but at least it's
your boy goes to the gym.
I'll make a plan.
I'll make a plan. Everyone will have enough.
I hope so. That baby's gonna be hard on everyone, especially Rebecca. And between you and me. She's not looking too good.
Hey, guys.
Yeah, well, she's about to have a baby, so, I mean, that just happens. Don't worry, I'm on that ass.
I just walked on in.
Oh my god, a zombie raccoon!
Figure it'd make a nice meal. We can eat raccoon?
I'd eat the shit.
Dude, it's cute, though.
Not like, I mean, just that I'd be really happy to.
That's nasty, I'd eat the shit out of that raccoon.
A long way with Rebecca.
I'd eat the corn right out of his shit. Oh my god, he saw us. Red alert, red alert. You flank him. I'm going in on his left side. I don't see him anywhere. You know.
There he is.
Raccoons are ferocious when they're cornered. Alright, you run over to the right side. Come on, catch him. Stomp him. Stomp him in the face.
Oh,
there he goes.
Shoot.
Oh no, he got away.
Dang it.
Yeah, take him out. Blast him.
Not with the walkers out there.
Oh, well, it's got babies. Never mind. Nah, we can't take them out. Raccoons are so cute. I was in the park one time.
I'm hungrier than I was before.
And I saw a garbage can, like, wiggling around. Kicked it over, and there was, like, 20 raccoons in there. It was so cute.
Well, I'm sort of glad it got away. It had a family.
Yeah, me too.
Come on, let's just get this back to Rebecca and the others.
They all rolled out and ran up a tree. It's hilarious. Yeah, there's probably some walkers coming anyway. We should dip. That's what we're about to do. We're gonna dip so hard.
I'm not supposed to be in labor yet, Kenny. What if something's wrong?
Nothing's wrong. Babies know how to be born.
How long did your son take?
All day.
How you doing?
2 days. Why'd you ask him that question, you insensitive?
I'm okay. How did you guys make out?
Sam's a bust. All glass walls shattered. It'd be impossible.
And it was picked over pretty good.
We found some water, though.
Oh, that's good. Nice work.
Kenny smiles. Yeah, Kenny smiles some more.
Save all of them for Rebecca. Anybody else gets a thirst, you can go to the river.
We should boil the water first, though, just in case, you know, somebody peed in it or something. Come on, Kenny. Come on, Kenny. Chin up, buddy. Buck up. I know that's tough to say after what happened,
hey,
but come on, man.
Glad
he's going to be like this for days, weeks.
How are you feeling?
Scared, and it hurts.
I think he'd be proud.
I'm really proud of you right now.
You think so?
You're a strong woman. I don't know why I'm being nice to you, because you're a huge bitch.
But I can't stop thinking about things I should have said to him.
I mean, you're about to go into labor. I don't need to add stress.
How am I ever
going to be a good mom? I'm just going to blow flowers up her butt. You're going to be the best mom. Your kid's not going to be a complete asshole in 10 years. I swear to God.
Glad you'll be there to watch out for this baby. Oh shit.
I got Maybe I should just take care of it.
I'm worried that we ain't seen Jane in a while. Go check on her, would you?
Yeah, go on ahead.
I think she might have run away. Ever get that when your head is like ridiculously itchy for no reason? Ooh, what's in the fan? You scratch it and it feels like the best thing in the world. Forsaken, but never forsaken. I mean, forgotten, but never forsaken. Something like that. I didn't really read it. I kind of read it, but didn't really pay attention. Ugh, come on, Clemmy, move. Ugh. Run, Bumber. I'll talk to her later. I'll be RB. Ooh, I should get her to, I should have got her to come with me. Just in case, you know, buddy system. That's the perfect building!
Jane?
Dude! She's probably just in there, checking it out. I mean, this is perfect. This is the exact thing that I was thinking about, you know, that would be the perfect building to have a baby inside of. Because there's probably like 10 little small rooms in there, I bet you. We should go in the office, because there's probably a cot in there. I bet you $5.
Hey, Clementine.
Eat, what up?
Here.
Nice. You did good, Jane? You did good. Oh, it's all locked down.
Okay.
How are we gonna get in there?
The museum was a bust, huh?
Yeah, it's all broken and smashed up. It would never be a safe place for Rebecca to have the baby.
I was afraid of that.
This thing looks like a vault.
This gate's still locked.
Dude!
Which means that hopefully no one's gotten to whatever was locked in there in the first place. I've been trying to get it open, but it's locked pretty tight. Can't see what's inside.
That could be a place for Rebecca to have the baby.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking.
And there's probably food in there. There's maybe some bandages. Probably just pork and beans, though.
A nail file?
Versatility is not overrated.
What are we gonna do? Serrate the lock off for 10 hours? Oh, she's gonna pick
it? Wouldn't hurt to try a heavier hand with this thing. See if you can find something bigger. All right. We might need to bust the mechanism.
Alright, maybe there's like a crowbar around. What if we just bash this cannon right through the wall? That'd be perfect. Man, there's a zip line too. Oh, doesn't go very far. I was really hoping this would be like Treehouse City. We could like zip line up and down. Zombies would never be intelligent enough to actually get up and down a zip line. Or a fireman's pole. Fireman's pole. We should go.
Find
yeah,
anything?
We should go to a fire station. That'd be perfect. Bummer. Alright, don't worry though. Don't worry though, Jane. I'm definitely gonna find something. Don't you worry about mine. I am a professional finder of things. Ooh, let's take a look. See if I can find any zombs in the immediate area. Zombs? Zombs? Zero zombs. I need 25 cents. Even during the zombie apocalypse. Those money grubbers. Alright, well, I'm gonna end it there, and we'll pick it up tomorrow, okay? Another great episode. Not as much happened this time, though. It was just kind of one of those episodes that kind of tells the story. I like those. I like how they kind of spread it out a bit so that it makes it more... It fleshes out the story, and it tells, like, a really, really personal story. Which is what I liked about Season 1. Anyways, see you tomorrow. Adios!